3, 2, 1, 0.
And we have many actors in different countries, governments and companies who envision and plan our long-term futures without a space. And these visions might be different and they might be competing, but what they all share is a similar concern: how to get to outer space and how to build the not yet known futures. My name is Nina Klimburg-Witjes. I'm an assistant professor at the Department for Science and Technology Studies, and I'm the PI of the research project Future Space that investigates the relations between European integration and Europe's future in outer space. Space is not removed or far away or remote. It's something that we use every day in our daily lives. We use it for navigation, we use it on our phones, for communication, banking. A lot of the data that we need for climate change monitoring and international crisis, we rely on space applications. And there is a global space race going on right now. So we have a lot of countries, governments, but also companies who envision, plan, and already materialize our outer space futures. And I think such an important realm that we need to not just leave it to the engineers or policymakers, but also as social scientists, understand what visions are articulated and who gets a say in how we want to live with an outer space in the future. And also with all the challenges that we currently see. For instance, we have orbits polluted by space junk, the leftovers of previous spaceflight activities. And how do we make sure that space remains open and accessible to everyone? And how do we make sure that we do not repeat the same mistakes that we made on Earth by polluting our environment, our global commons? So what we look at in the current research project is at the European rocket Ariane. It's a rocket that is built by 13 European countries and part of the only multinational space program in the world. And we look at practices of European integration, their tensions and their ideals on the ground, and how these translate into visions of Europe's future in outer space. So my advice to young researchers: don't be afraid to speak out. I think in particular for female researchers, when you're at conferences, your ideas matter, and just trust in that. But also with all the curiosity and excitement, it's not an easy career path. And I think it's important that you have a plan where you want to be and how you realistically can get there.